I always admire writing on mechanical parts, and I always dream of being able to write letters and numbers in an orderly and repeatable way. In a world where the laser is now king, I decide on an old-style project with manual punches. The first idea was that of a viewfinder, with the idea of aiming, fixing, and then punching. I then thought that a sliding cursor with the viewfinder on board would give me the freedom to decide the step or the pitch between a letter or a number and more. I therefore decide to give an appearance similar to a measuring instrument. For this, I choose the contrast between the brass and the polished steel. The viewfinder was definitely the most complex part, because I didn't know how to make it. Then, by chance, I fixed my eye on the white wooden box where the sewing needles are contained. And there was the starting point of my project. I decided to slide the cursor with two guides of different heights. The highest guide is used for the locking screw, so as not to damage the surface. The upper sliding part does not touch the piece to be punched, and the brass part is held in the guide by 4M6 threaded pins, which I decide to block with a special Loctite for bearings. I show how useful the small gauge is for accurately measuring the depth of machining with the piece under the spindle. In this way, there is a feedback on the depth of the machining just performed. My milling machine proved once again to be very accurate, especially when working on a light material such as brass, where it is very easy to undersize. Working brass is at the same time very easy but very complicated, because it is a very soft material. Therefore, even to make small machining operation, it is necessary to apply small machining depths, because it is very easy to make a mistake in the measurement. When the mating parts have finally been done, you can relax by doing the chamfers, which even at low speed come out really shiny. The viewfinder was definitely the most complex part, because I didn't really know how to make it. And the final idea came out when I decided to slide the cursor with two guides of different heights. In that moment, the idea to make a small hole arrived in my mind. The highest guide is used for the locking screw, so as not to damage the surface. I did think that I'd be able to make a 0.8mm hole in the steel in particular. To avoid breaking the tip, I drill a hole from the center, deeper than usual, so as to not only give a better guide to the tip, but also allow the discharge of the tips. I also decide to test the viewfinder on a simple line written on my vise, to test the visibility of the needle inside the hole made in brass. I must say that I really like the results, and for this reason I also apply it to the mobile cursor to indicate the pitch between one punching and the other one. When punching takes place, the part to be punched rests on a 12 mm steel plate, in which I have made not only the holes to mount the four support pins, but also a slot in which to insert a 45 V-shape insert, lockable with a small M4 screw. The insert in the base of my device with the 45 degree B-shape hole, it can be rotated. For flat details, the V must face downwards. For round details, instead, the V must face upwards, and you will see the results on the round bar at the end. Usually, the codes written on a round surface must be written in a plane obtained from a milling machine. In my case, I finally perform a test on the rolled round surface to see if the letters had come aligned anyway. Then I had fun building four M6 threaded pins, in which the only difficult part was the insertion diameter in the base, because the hole was made with a drill bit, and therefore I had to try first if the diameter was wide or narrow. In making the cursor, I have to be very careful of the central passage hole, in order not to find a misalignment with the punch passage slot. With my cutter, it took me 1 hour to completely machine the cursor from solid. Each pass was 0.3 mm, with an end mill of 14 mm in diameter, which I did not exaggerate with the number of revolution in order not to generate high vibration. Instead, the use of the T-shaped cutter required a low number of revolution per minute, because the side that cuts is not a point, but it's a line, and therefore the effort is greater. I then finish the square hole by hand with my small file. I always prefer steel to iron, because even if the efforts are not great, with steel you always get very nice surface finish. With iron instead, it is more difficult, because it is softer and lets you tear, not cut. To build the V-shaped support, the greatest amount of time was to position the piece in line and at the angle of 45 degrees, because then the amount of the material removed with the vertical machine was very little. I took advantage of the possibility of polishing my pieces with vibration and nutshells, and I must say that the results was very good. The best, obviously, was on the brass. But I probably would have got a better result on the steel, waiting more time. But I am happy with it. The surface of both pieces is really good. I did not find any problems during assembly. Just maybe a little too much precision in making the four holes on the top. But I think over the time there will be some play, because the brass is softer than the steel. I concentrated on the surface finish because I'd want to obtain an appearance similar to that of a measuring instrument. I also made the couplings, hoping then the precision would also be reflected in the punching. I found it very convenient to be able to insert the pieces and then tighten them with the knurled nuts. Of course, being four nuts, you need to pay a minimum of attention so as not to position the piece not horizontally. Here I show you, it can be seen from above before punching. As you can see, the cursor has the zero along the metric line very clearly. Therefore, once the pitch has been decided, just tighten the knurled nut. The first writing I tested was the word pizza, a really famous Italian name, and I was very and really exciting to see the first result. For this first test, I use a standard pitch of 6 mm to see how my device behaved, and I must say that the first result was excellent for me. I thought of using aluminum to better show the stamped letter, but obviously steel can also be used. After trying pizza, I had to try the word pepperoni. Obviously, changing the pitch between one letter and the other. And also, in this case, I got a good result. And why not try to write ciao, a very famous Italian word, with a pitch of 10 mm. And here is another good result, as you see in the picture. Of course, the most exciting part was writing on the round bar. And I must say that here too I was satisfied with my writing support. I wrote the word good in 1977, which is my year of birth. I really hope that you enjoyed my video. So, thanks for watching. A Bishop.